बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू द कैंटर पब्लिशर्स वीडियो लेसन्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन, डियर स्टूडेंट, यू मस्ट हैव विद यू क्लास 8 इंग्लिश टेक्स्ट बुक। वी विल स्टार्ट अवर लेसन फ्रॉम यूनिट नंबर 2, मीडिया एज सोर्स ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन। SLOs ऑफ दिस लेसन आर क्लासीफाई, यूज, कन्वर्ट एंड मेक डिक्लेरेटिव, अफर्मेटिव एंड नेगेटिव, इंट्रोगेटिव, एक्सक्लेमेटरी एंड इंपेरेटिव सेंटेंसेस। Analyze and use sentences with direct and indirect object. In our previous lesson, we discussed the kinds of sentences, the simple and the compound, and the phrase and the clause. Now, we will discuss the types of sentences. Look at the page number 24 of your textbook. There are 4 types of sentences. Assertive or declarative sentence, a statement, a simple statement. Imperative sentence, a command. When we give order or give command to someone, and interrogative sentence, when we ask a question from someone, and it's always end with the question mark, and exclamatory sentence, an exclamation in which we use exclamation. Let's discuss it one by one. An assertive sentence is a sentence that state a fact. Such sentence as simple statements, they state, assert or declare something. They tell you about something or give a statement or declare something. I want to be a good doctor. It is a declarative sentence. This person is telling you about that, he is declaring that he want to be a good writer. It's just a statement, makes a statement. My friend is really good writer. It expresses an opinion. This is both sentences includes in the assertive sentence. This, because this is an opinion statement, a declarative sentence and a simple sentence here. Declarative sentence that have a negative meaning are called negative sentence. Negative sentences are the opposite of affirmative sentence. Look at here the examples. The balloon is red, it is not blue. Here the not indicates that it is a negative sentence here. The man has a horse and he does not have a dog here. These two sentences here, the affirmative, and this is the total opposite sentences we have. Negative sentence, we have it here, does not or not here. It is completely opposite. Here it is making the statement and expresses an opinion, but here in these negative sentences, it is totally denying the facts or statement here by using does not or is not. Now look at the second one. Imperative sentences is a sentence which gives a command, makes a request or express a wish. For example, go to your room. This is an order or a command here. Please lend me your book. This is a request here. Have a good time at the picnic. This is a wish here. To wish him to have a good time. Look at the third one. Exclamatory sentence is a sentence that expresses sudden and strong feelings such as surprise, wonder, pity, sympathy, happiness or gratitude. Gratitude matlab shukar guzar hona kisi ka. For example, what a shame. This is the feeling of pity or sympathy. Boy, I am tired. This is the feeling of tiredness here. Oh, I am sad. Wow, I got so happy. These are the examples of exclamatory sentence which express the strong feelings. Look at the fourth one, interrogative sentence. A sentence that asks a question is called an interrogative sentence. I told you in the start, a sentence which also includes have a question mark at the end because it is an interrogative form when we ask question from someone. What is your name? Where do you live? This is a question form here. We interrogating someone. Now look at the direct and indirect objects in a sentence. What these are? Let's first discuss the direct object first. A direct object answers the question what or whom. For example, Akmal repaired his car. His car is the direct object of the verb repaired. What did Akmal repair? His car. Here the Akmal is subject here and his direct object is in on which the activity is done, the action is done is his car here. Now look at the second one. He invited Maria to the party. Maria is the direct object of the verb invited. Whom did he invite? Maria here. Here the subject is he and he invited the action here and on which the action is done on Maria here. Object can be both thing or people or animal. It can be anything, direct object, but it depend upon the sentence in which context we are talking about. Now look at the indirect object here. An indirect object answers the questions to whom, for what. An indirect object is the recipient of the direct object or otherwise affected participant in the event. There must be a direct object for an indirect object to be placed in a sentence. In other words, an indirect object cannot exist without a direct object. Look at the example first. They sent him a postcard. Him is the indirect object of the verb sent. To whom did they send a postcard? To him. He bought his son a bike. His son is the indirect object here of the verb bought. For whom did he buy a bike? For his son. To learn this concept, you have to learn this first. To whom, for whom, or for what. And in the direct object, what or whom. This is the simple way of remembering both these two concepts. Now look at the page number 26. We have an exercise of types of sentences here. Choose the type of sentence shown in each question. You have to choose for each sentence the right option here. Look at the first one here. Stop, I'm sick and tired of your excuses. Yes, we have an exclamation mark here. So we have the exclamation mark in a sentence. So it is very obvious that it is exclamatory sentence. It is indicating or referring to the strong feelings or emotions here. Look at the second one. Slow down before you get into an accident. This is a opinion statement here. So what will be the no exclamatory? No, we don't have any feelings here, or exclamation mark, interrogative. No, we don't have any question mark here, declarative or imperative. No, it's not declaring anything. So it's an imperative sentence. Yes. Look at the third one. I would say anything to make you angry. Now this is not a statement. A person is expressing his feeling here. I would say anything to make you angry. This is not exclamatory, not interrogatory, not imperative. Yes, it is a declaration about his feeling that he could do anything to make him angry. Now look at the fourth one here. Please pass the salt. This is a statement, a simple sentence here. So this is a imperative. Yes, this is not a declaration, or we don't have any exclamation and question mark here. So it is obvious this is an imperative sentence here. Look at the fifth one. Did I say anything to make you angry? Yes, we have a question mark here and it's very clear it's an interrogative sentence. Now look at the sixth one. It is training cats and dogs. Now this is a declaration here. Yes, it would be a declarative sentence. Now look at the seventh here. I want to become a writer. The same example we have discussed in the lesson earlier. Yes, this is also a declarative sentence because it is declaring that he wants to become a writer here. Now look at the eighth one. She does not eat meat or fish. This is not an opinion or statement here, not interrogative and exclamatory. So it is a declarative. Yes, it's a declaration that she does not eat meat or fish here. I want you to do the rest 8 sentences by yourself. This is your homework from summer pack. This is also your homework from summer pack, page number 11. This is from page number 12 of your summer pack. And also we have a activity here. Role play a dialogue involving your friend and yourself. Create different situation in which you both can ask questions, respond to them, or reacting to any event happening. यूज द टाइप्स ऑफ सेंटेंसेज affirmative, interrogative, imperative and exclamatory. It's your sentences and it's your friend's sentences. You have to role play a dialogue. I hope you will do your homework. Thank you.